Hello，大家好，我是 Terry。最近的美国科技公司裁员还是持续不断，但是拿到 offer 的人还是非常的多。其实我觉得这一连串的操作呢，就是换血员工，把不必要的岗位给砍掉，然后引进一波新的愿意为公司卖命的人才。尤其是现在所有的公司都在转型 AI。那我知道有一些看我频道的观众其实是想要来美国的，尤其是来美国矽谷那边工作，不只有诱人的收入，你的履历上面有 Fang 或者有 Manga，看起来就比较屌。所以我今天特别邀请到 Chloe Xu。Chloe 自己本身有一个 YouTube 频道，然后她的 LinkedIn 上面有超过10万个追踪，我觉得这个真的蛮屌的。LinkedIn 上面有10万个追踪真的不简单，而且她还曾经入选过富比士30 Under 30。那 Chloe 的背景是资深产品经理，她曾经在 Google、Meta、TikTok、Discord 工作过。今天特别来西雅图跟大家分享一下怎么培养个人能力，还有她谈薪水拿 offer 的背后故事。另外呢，Chloe 本身是在 LA 出生长大的，所以她中文真的不是很好，希望大家不要见谅。但是呢，在这集访谈的过程中间呢，我也会尽量用中文跟她说话。
Okay, yeah, it's Chloe. She was a PM，之前在 Tech 工作，然后今天特别来西雅图，
对，
来，
很久没来过，
很久没来。这上一次来西雅图是什么时候？
好像是10年前诶。
哦，啊。
呀，大学的时候，
Chloe 是美国长大的，
对，洛杉矶。
上次有一个老师也是来我的频道，跟大家聊一下关于 PM 相关的内容啊。今天特别再次邀请 Chloe 来，Chloe 在这个 Bay Area，是美国旧金山那边，有蛮多经验的。就是你以前读的东西跟你现在做的是没有关系，对吧？
完全没有关系。
Right，那你为什么最后选择来进来 Tech 工作？
Okay, I did management engineering in the Claremont Colleges, and then, yeah, IUR at Columbia. But then, 大部分的人在 Columbia, 如果他们选这个的话, they go to Wall Street to do banking, like investment banking.
Oh, okay.
And I did not like that at all. So I always knew I wanted to go to tech. And then I moved over, but I was like, oh, everyone's doing software engineering, but I don't want to do that. I'm a people person. I did a lot of leadership clubs, and then I wanted to go into...like something more people related, so I joined Google doing people operations.
Right. 所以 Chloe 之前是读 operational research, 就是 industrial engineering, 工业工程，跟我以前也是一样。要不要跟大家分享一下，就是你怎么进入这个当 PM 这个工作的？
对，所以我一开始是 people operations, 然后后来就觉得 maybe this is not for me, and then I went to more like data oriented jobs and interviews. I found a 新创公司 a startup. I joined it as one of the first non-technical hires doing business development, and it was in the streaming space, so 直播。So I would go work with gaming companies and live streamers and do partnership deals. I realized the streamers, 当一个博主很累很难，然后赚钱很难。And they have so many problems that like they have so much tech. And I realized, wow, we can solve so many things if we build XYZ feature. So I would take their pain points, bring it back to the product team and be like, we need to build this. I can't sell the product faster than you building it because...Doesn't matter how good I am, if the product is not good, then we can't do it. So then I realized that was like product management. And then I learned more about the career, and I was like, oh, in Silicon Valley, in tech, 当一个 PM 有很多能力 and leadership and prestige. So I feel, wow, this is something that has longevity, and I don't know where my current career is going to go, but product can go so far. They're considered like mini CEOs of the company. And lastly, I think that product management pays really well, so 薪水很高。对，
讲到薪水，我觉得
你喜欢这个 topic，
不是我喜欢，我觉得我的观众喜欢，大家应该很好奇，在矽谷工作这么多年，这个薪水大概是怎么样，跟大家分享一下。
So actually I had a hard time transitioning from business development to product. After the 新创公司 I went to Facebook to do product operations. So it's not PM, it's just like PM's work with product operations. And then 在 Facebook 我有做 PM 的工作 like I was the PM for this small product, but I wasn't by title. And I was making like 95K, and I had like equity and stuff, but it's not a lot.
I think the first job is like underpaid, right?
Yeah, I've been underpaid my entire career.
Yeah.
If you're not in product engineering data, then literally your pay is so much lower than everyone else. So just like changed everything.
大家以为可能在 Fan 只要在里面工作薪水都很高，其实不一定，一定要在 EPD engineering product design or data.Right.
其实在旧金山如果你赚 less than 10万 you're considered low income. It's very hard to live in San Francisco for that amount. So when I got the TikTok offer, I actually got a senior PM role for 18万 base salary, 25% target bonus, 217,000 in equity over 4 years, and it was a total first year comp of $279,000. So I feel like it changed my life.
Yeah, Meta was trying to rip you off.
Yeah.
You're working as a PM, but then you're getting paid as an op.
因为在大公司做这些 transfer 的事情就是很麻烦、takes like a long time. It really did change my life. It went from like I had to budget everything to now I don't have to look at. So that was TikTok.
How about Discord?
They gave me a lower offer at the beginning, but I negotiated, and I'm pretty good at negotiating. I went from 180 base to a 215K base.
Pretty impressive.
Which is pretty good because it's the same level.
Yeah.
Then I got a 50K sign-on bonus, and then I got equity. And the equity, unfortunately, I can't really talk about because the numbers are just like up and down, but it's in the multi-six figures.
Wow.
Yeah, multi-six figures for every year.
Has it gone down or?
I guess when I signed my offer, it was good, and then it went up, and then it kind of went down a bit. Yeah. And we're still, it's still not public yet, so I don't even know.
Yeah, cool. Why don't you share a little bit more about product manager? 你需要哪一些 skill 可以让你变成很成功的 product manager?
So in tech, the product manager owns the why and the what we're building. Like, why are we building this and what is it that we're building? And the engineers and designers and everyone else works on the how we build it and let's build it and get it to launch. Mm-hmm. So as a product manager, you have to have extremely strong product sense to figure out why you're building something and leadership to convince everyone else that this is the right move and then have really strong executional skills to spec out exactly what it looks like, how it works. Honestly, your boss will just say, we need to grow by 10%, go. And you just have to take that and then break down everything to the problem and figure out where we can go from there and build innovative solutions. And also another essential skill set is user empathy, like being able to convert your customer insights to product tactical to-dos and action items is such a superpower that you need to build. What do you think makes a great PM versus a PM that you just hate working with?
Yeah, I think it all comes down to communication, probably like the key. If you know how to talk to engineers, that'll be a pretty good plus. You'll get a lot of respect for engineers. Which is good. You want that, right?
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah.
You get it.
我自己的背景是软体工程。像我们要去找工作的时候 we do lead code.
Oh, yeah.
你们如果要找工作的话面试会需要准备很多这些东西吗
当然啦、啊、There's so many case questions, like hundreds and hundreds.、
Mm.
Yeah, it's like there's product sense interview, product execution interview, the strategy ones. Maybe we do a presentation on our product work or they will give us a prompt and you present it and then like engineers and designers and PMs will come and just nitpick at it and give feedback. It's kind of like a product review. And、you do product sense, which is like, can you design a biking app for San Francisco? What does that look like? Or how do you build a wedding engagement ring app? That's stuff like that. And then you have to go through that question over 45 minutes.
听起来好像也是花很多时间要准备。
对，要花很多，because there's like frameworks that...
You can kind of follow and just...practice those questions.
There's like an expected answer, basically.
Oh, okay.
They're looking for how well you can think on the spot and what's your decision-making framework.
有很多观众其实有私讯问我说现在就整个 tech 的环境怎么样就 lay off 这些像 Chloe 之前也被 lay off 我也是被 lay off 所以你觉得被 lay off 完之后有没有什么感受
就是发生的时候 I wasn't that surprised. 在 tech 里面在 Silicon Valley actually 40% of Americans get laid off in their career. And so it's a pretty normal thing in at least in the United States. But with tech layoffs, I think the only thing is like, pretty sad. Anyway, what tells you on Discord? And then just like bittersweet. And then you just move on to the next thing. I always feel I have to work all the time. I can't really take vacation. And every year it's like new goals. I can finally reset, take a moment to think about what I want in my life. And all of a sudden, all of these doors open for me. I had so many conversations with startups, with educational institutions. If I was in a role, I would just always say no to everyone. But now all of these doors are opening and I feel really excited for my next chapter.
但我听说 Discord 很厉害就是你们的 engineering 其实很小但是你们的 scope 很超大
因为 我进入 Discord 的时候 I think there's only like 8 PM in the whole company. Even when I left, it was only like 25. One product team takes on so much surface area. It's kind of crazy. It's really fun. Gotta do a lot of 0-1.
0-1, 对。
0-1 launch.
Nice. Chloe, 我看你的 Instagram 上面之前在台湾拍了一些东西。我跟大家分享一下。
好啊。三月的时候回台湾 for 3 weeks. 我跟一个 educational tech company called 知识卫星 work together as a 老师。I'm so excited because actually 去年12月我有去台湾做一个 career talk for a cake resume and then talk about my product career. And from that, 知识卫星 reached out and was like, teaching product thinking, help tech in Taiwan. When this opportunity came up, I was like, yes, I would love to. So I went back, I shot the course 3 weeks, every day, 9 to 6, and we finally put together one of the most comprehensive courses on product thinking in the industry. It's 8 to 10 hours long. I'd cover everything from breaking into product to what do you do in the product role to how do you think like a product manager. It's not just for PMs. It's for like anyone who wants to build the skill set for the future of their business. More of like my first steps into helping Tech for Taiwan.
假如今天去上你的这课，那我可以学到什么东西？
There are four. 这四个部分。The first one is I don't know how to say in Chinese. It's like
大环境。
Big picture thinking. 就是每天你做一些很小的事情 you don't know why you're doing it. And you're like, if you take a step back, does that really fall in line with the vision and the impact? And is this actually achieving something bigger? So you'll get a sense of that. Because we go through a bunch of case studies on all kinds of companies. And so you'll see how those are broken down. The second is problem solving, where you get that hard question. Your boss is like, we need to raise revenue by 20%. We need to double everything. Go, go do it. And it's like a really scary question. So how do you do that? You use first principles thinking.I think the best example that I know is like you have to improve the speed of an elevator and you're like, that's a lot of work. But then maybe if you like break down the problem, maybe the problem is customers feel that it's slow. You don't necessarily have to fix the elevator. Maybe you can add a mirror, add some music, add an iPad. So it feels like the time is passing by faster. It's a much lower cost way of solving the problem. Now you can go on to other problems that are probably more important. So that's what first principles is very much like. The third is user-centric approach, building your user empathy, customer insights, like how do you go from all these customer interviews and user interviews and taking that and building actual product insights and a plan of action for your product team. I think anyone who builds a product or owns a business, you have to know what your audience, your customers want and create an action plan from it. Lastly, it's data-driven thinking. So obviously you have your opinion, I have my opinion. We can argue all day, but the one thing that will align us clearly is data.
Yeah.
So how do you do experimentation? How do you take analytics and take those numbers and tell a story that can align everyone so we can just go start executing immediately? So those are the four components.
Cool.
Yeah.
我是真心觉得啊，就是这个 course 虽然 focus product， 但是应该就像我自己是 engineer 嘛，那我在 tech 工作里面，假如我想要再往上走，比如说我要再更做得更 senior， 可能我想要当 EM 或者我要当 people manager， 那我觉得这些 skill 其实都是要有的。就这个 course 从工程师的角度去看的话，我觉得是一个可以让我自我成长，增加一些我自己其他除了技术之外的一些比较弱的一些项目。比如说你来跟我讲话的话，我就知道说、你的 reasoning 是什么，就你从哪里来的，为什么你会这样想。对，可能花很多时间做，
超多时间，
我会感觉出来那个东西做完真的是很累的，
十个小时的很多。
这个 course 十个小时呢
？Yeah, I put everything into it. 而且也不是只是我去做这个 course，
就整个 team 做，花很多时间的做。
Yeah.So I wrote the entire course. Then I'm like, 我去要求我的朋友 They work at SoundCloud, Riot Games, Uber, Fair, Headspace, Spotify, Figma, Discord, Instagram, and Twitch to review everything and give me their input.
Feedback, right?
Yeah, because obviously product is, we work with everyone. And so we can't just think in our own space. I was able to work with so many people in the industry to review and share their perspective.
Nice.
Yeah.
Nice. 对吧、啊、那现在 Chloe 特别飞来西雅图其实就是想要跟大家分享这个 course 嘛。那这课程呢从5月23号到6月30号是早鸟优惠有4折，那如果用这个影片底下的折扣码的话可以再折300块台币。那大家有兴趣的话可以去看一下，我觉得不只是对产品经理，就是任何想要进 tech 或是想要对 tech 对产品 sense 有兴趣，想要练习你的 critical thinking skill 或是你的 product skill 的话都可以去了解一下。那也感谢 Chloe 特别飞过来。
谢谢 Terry for having me.